Hello everyone, welcome to Tangle with Tracy Anne. This week I'll be showing you how to create a beautiful antique bronze effect. For this project you could use one of Zentangle's Phi Tiles. I find the shipping a little bit expensive here in Australia, so I've cut mine out of this Strathmore Bristol paper.
Thank you.
to creative bronze effect, I'm using Prismacolor pencils. You could use similar colours in a different brand and it would give you the same effect. I'm going to start with very light layers using my darkest colours, and that's in the areas where you might see shadow. I'll gradually add colours, and you can see them, which colours I'm using on the screen, until I finally built up that lovely bronze effect. Leave highlighted areas in white if you want a nice glossy metallic look. There are lots of YouTube videos out there from colouring books where people are creating these beautiful metallic looks, and one in particular that I found useful was My Coloring Craze, and I'll put a link to that below this video if you want to go and check that out.
Thank you.
Now that you've got the idea of how to build up this bronze colour, I'll speed through the rest of the video. It did take a couple of hours, so take your time, build up your layers gradually, and enjoy the process. If you find that your paper is still looking a little bit grainy, I'm going to use this colourless blender to just flatten that tooth a little bit and make it look a little bit smoother. be very careful that you don't smudge that black if you've used a black pencil, because it will mucky up what you've put underneath. If you like, you could go in with a black pen, and be careful what you use here because the Pigma pens tend to clog up. So you could sharpen up the black a little bit with a pen if you like, but it's okay to just leave it with the pencil. If you find that you haven't got enough white paper and it's not having that glossy kind of look, you could go back in with an eraser, and I'm using this Tombow very fine eraser. Once you've built up the layers though, it can get a little bit tacky and you'll find that it's hard to remove it. So these mechanical erasers are a really good idea. And you can see it's just taking that little bit of pencil to create a nice little highlight and make my piece look a little bit more metallic. You can always touch up areas with your pencils if you need to, if it's been damaged by the erasing. So there's my bronze looking effect. If you don't have coloured pencils, you could just do the same pattern and shade it. So I'll quickly run through how you'd do that.
I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. If you haven't already subscribed to my YouTube channel, do that so that you don't miss out on future videos. I do post one every Wednesday. Thank you for watching, and until next week, stay safe and bye for now. If you'd like to see more of my videos, head over to my YouTube channel, or there are a couple of links here on the screen, and there's the subscribe button.